Good morning to one and all. In the previous class we discussed about this design of super elevation. Normally super elevation is represented with the word small e elevation. The super elevation itself, elevation e, both are related, so that this elevation is represented with small e. Small e equal to v square by 127 r, which is related to velocity in terms of meter per second, and v square by 225 r, it is related to velocity in kilometer per hour. Normally we are having elevation plus friction also, but in some cases we are neglecting this frictional forces, so that only we are considering elevation. We are having e equal to v square by 127 r or 225 r, depending upon their velocity in terms of meter per second and kilometer per hour. We are having discussed these alignments, so that these are the crown align. We need to neglect this crown, different types of crown shifted outwards and crown shifted inwards, and alignments of super elevation with respect to central axis, and these are the alignment with respect to inner edge. These four things we discussed in the previous class. These are the alignments with respect to top view, both with respect to central axis and inner edge. First diagram, where I have first is the top elevation of the particular super elevation curve, horizontal curve, and in the second row we are having super elevation with respect to central axis. That means at the midpoint they are considering super elevation. In the third row we are having elevation with respect to inner edge, while they are considering with respect to inner edge. Those three are the pictorial representation for super elevations and their alignments with respect to inner edge and central axis. How the alignment look like in a particular span of the road. This is the outer edge and inner edge with respect to central axis and other one. Next one is the inner edge. Those two things are described here with respect to diagrams and their thickness values along the central lines. And next, these are examples we discussed in the previous class. In some of the examples, they are directly giving elevations and friction values. Only we need to calculate velocity of the curve. In some of the problems, they are having four terms. We are mainly in that problem ads. We are having four terms. First one is the velocity. Third, second one elevation. Third one friction. Next, fourth one radiation. In those four terms, we are having three terms. We need to calculate one term. This is the main rule. That means in whatever the problem itself, we have to calculate any of the one term which was not given in the problem. Those four terms are mainly velocity, elevation, friction, and radius of the curve. Those four terms are involved in these four problems. These are the two problems. In this case, we are having another two set of problems, example 3 and 4. In this, design the super elevation for a hard highway of 500 and speed is kmph. That means they directly giving radius of the curve, that means r value they have given, and speed, that means in terms of velocity they are given. Simply in terms of friction equal to, we have to take it as 0. Simply e equal to v square by 227 r. Why? Because here we are having speed in terms of 100 kmph. If the speed is in terms of meter per second, we have to take 127 r. E equal to v square by 225 r, where v equal to 100 into 100, r equal to 500. Okay, we need to equate those and we have to get elevation, how much amount of elevation we have to kept. In the example 4 itself also, we are having design speed of highway is 80 kmph. Both the problems are having design speed in terms of kilometers per hour. We no need to worry. But the second problem, the radius of the curve is 200 meters on a certain locality. Calculate the super elevation need to maintain on those particular speed, such that both are having, the first one we are having national highways, other one we are having state highways, so that their speed is limited to 100 kmph and 80 kmph. National highway and state highway, for those two kinds of cases, they are directly giving radius of the curve 500 meters and second one we are having 200 meters. Only we need to calculate what is the elevation required for particular span of the road. So the simple problems, formula is easy, E equal to V square by 127R, E equal to V square by 225R. Those two are the formulas varying, remaining all are same. In this diagram, in this chart, we are having design speeds on rural roads. That means rural means where there is a city conditions, those are called rural roads. Urban road means where there are not related to this. Rural means where there are villages, those are called rural roads. And there are urbanization means urban roads we are having, rural roads, urban roads normally. But here road classification, design speed in terms of kilometers with respect to terrains. Normally we are having a plain terrain, rolling terrain, steep terrains and mountainous terrains. Okay, these four types of terrains we are having. All these are the recommendations given by the Indian Road Congress. How much amount of speed we need to maintain on those particular terrain with particular vehicle or speed. Express ways we are having. Normally express ways in plain terrain we are maintaining 120 kmph. And the minimum speed we have to maintain is 100 kilometers. Similarly, as well as rolling terrains, we have to maintain 100 and minimum of 80. In mountainous terrain, 80, 60. In steep terrains, we have to maintain a minimum 80, 60. Both are same. With respect to these express ways, normally express ways are meant for huge amount of speed. That means whenever we have to go for a particular distance with less span of time, we have to prefer these expressways. Why? Because all the vehicular traffic is similarly going without any obstructions. Next one we are having with these state highways and national highways. Normal speed of these national highways is 100 km per hour. That means kmph, 100 km per hour. In the different terrains they are giving. First one, plain terrain, maximum value is the 100 km and minimum value is 80 kilometers. Similarly, in a rolling terrains, we are having rolling terrains, rolling gradients, we are having 80 kilometers, 65 kilometers. After that, we are having mountainous 50, 40, and steep terrains. That means where there is a less span of distance between two roads, those are called steep. In those places, we have to maintain 40, 30. And next we are having major district road, MDR, ODR and village roads. Those are having similar but with respect to few changes. Normally these major district roads having a speed of 80 kmph. But in case of minimum speed we have to maintain 65. Likely rolling terrains also we have to maintain 65 and 50. After that we are having mountainous. In those mountainous cases we have to maintain 40, 30. After that we have to maintain steep terrain with a values of 30 kilometers and 20 kilometers speed. Okay, similarly other district roads we are having a speeds. All those things are not remembering. That means remembering those values is not possible. Why? Because they are directly given as tabular forms. That means all those are prescribed in a Indian Road Congress. They have given directly to this officers which are working on those particular roads and other design purposes. So they have to see those values and they have to implement on those particular curves. That means whenever there is a curve, for that particular curve, the curve is located on which location and which kind of road the curve is designed. It is a national highway, how much speed we have to maintain. For that speed, what elevation we have to required. It is a horizontal curve or vertical curve, or it is located in plain terrain or rolling terrain. All those things they have to consider. After considering all those things and conditions, they have to give particular values. And what are the overtaking distance required? Is there any extra widening is required for those particular roads? Okay, while designing a road, all those are different cases and conditions we need to know to eliminate these accidents and other traffic jams. If there is no accident means, so the design is very much
efficient. If there is huge amount of access, means there may be a faulty design or any constructional errors or dimensional errors are made in the particular designs. So that we need to have a proper vision while designing a design. Next one is the radius of the horizontal curve. What is a horizontal curve? Previously we discussed horizontal curves and vertical curves. What is the radius of the horizontal curve? In minimum radius we have to go for a design speed with respect to meter per second and meter per kilometer per hour is given by R ruling. That means ruling gradients and minimum gradients previously we discussed. In this tabular form itself we are having plain terrain, rolling terrain, not ruling, rolling terrain. Plain, rolling, mountainous, steep, those are related to terrain conditions. But in case of second, we are having ruling and minimum. That means ruling values and minimum values we have to take. Ruling values means normal rules applied for those particular designs. And minimum rules, what is the maximum value, minimum value, like that. Ruling is the maximum value. Next one is we are having minimum value. In case of these horizontal curves, that means where there is an intersection of particular roads, so that we are simply connecting those two roads with the help of these radial patterns to avoid particular jams and other conditions, traffic jams and other accidents at particular joints. So that these curves are involved to increase the traffic flow particular areas. So that we are having these ruling gradients and minimum gradients. To calculate those ruling gradients, mainly involved, R means there are radius for this ruling gradient is directly proportional to velocity and indirectly proportional to E, that means elevation and friction of that particular pavement. In some of the conditions, they are directly asking a few bits. That means in the design of horizontal curve, the radius is directly proportional to, that means velocity. Indirectly proportional to this elevation and frictional forces between tires and pavements. So we have to remember like that also. Rolling gradient, minimum gradient. Both conditions we are having 127. The absolute minimum radius. But in case of here we are having a V dash. That means V dash means, V means normally we are having maximum speed. V dash means we have to go for a minimum speed. That means normally expressways we are having 120 kmph. That means it is a maximum ruling value and 100 kmph is the minimum value. Those things we have to mention here. What is V and what is V dash? At the end of this PPT we are having plenty of these diagrams. Those diagrams will show, that means what is extra widening, what is a vertical terrain, ruling terrain. By using those images, that means pictorial representations, we have to observe and we have to visualize what is a terrain, what is extra widening, where these curves are implemented, what is the purpose of introducing these curves, how we have to eliminate these accidents and traffic jams. All those things we need to have a better ideas while observing those pictures in the last slides. Why? Because if we kept the slides in between these values, simply we have a confusion. What is the rolling terrain? What is the plain terrain? Minimum radius, maximum radius, all those having some sort of confusion. So that I kept those diagrams on the end of the session. Because at the end of the session, we have a clarification. What is the radius of the curve in plain terrain, what we have to maintain, rolling terrain we have to maintain, steep terrains and mountainous terrains, which kind is applicable. Okay, we will go to this table 4.1.1. this table that was normally related to these design speeds in terms of rural highways. Next one, we are having minimum radius we have to maintain on those particular curves, national highways, major district roads, other district roads and village roads. In the primary having, we are having expressways and others. Already we seen this diagram, that means we seen this table in the previous slide, but we have not observed these radiuses. That means why? Because we have to compare what is the speed and what is the radius we are having. That means national highways, the speed is maintaining as 100 km/h and 80 km/h. In those having, what is the radius we have to keep to. That means 360 and 230. After that, we are having rolling terrain, mountainous terrain, steep terrains. Okay. What are the different factors involved on those village roads and other district roads and others? So those things we need to discuss, and we have to compare what is the maximum values, minimum values in national highways and state highways and major district roads, other district roads. Why we have to keep like this? Because of flow of vehicle is very much speed in national highways when compared to major district roads and other district roads. Why? Because we need to go with a long span of drive with a short span of time, so that basically for those kind of situations we will prefer national highways. For getting a smaller distance with a smaller time, we will not prefer those conditions. Next, the other one, we are having major district roads and other district roads. In the major district roads, the normal principle of laying these major district roads is to have some bonding between different districts in the state level, and the transportation system also majorly done by using national highways. At some points we have to meet with these districts. Why? Because in the national highways we need to go with a huge span of speed, so that our time will be saved while preferring these national highways and the express highways. Simply going on major district roads means we have to face a huge amount of traffic, so that our vehicular time will be delayed. So to prevent those time factors, we have to choose whatever the road we have and what way we have to go, and particularly the vehicle, the material properties also. While we are traveling in a particular roads, we need to take our vehicular properties and material properties. If there is any vegetable load or any other smooth loads we are dealing, that means we need to definitely go on this national highways, because there may be a plain surface of the road, and compared to others they are having some irregularities and other speed breakers and other traffic regulations. So that by facing those, the total material will be having some sort of damage. To prevent those, we have to choose our better road and better speed properties. Why? Because the material is very much important. These are the different combinations of speeds and other things. Those things are not have to remember, because it is not possible to remember all of those. Simply while we are designing a particular roads, we need to have these values. What is the minimum value? What is the maximum value? What are the different conditions? Next one, we are having here example. Calculate the values of ruling minimum and absolute minimum radius of pattern horizontal curve for a national highway in plain terrain. Assume design speed of the maximum speed of the values are 180 respectively. That means 180 means both are in kilometers per hours. That means in the example itself, they are giving daily directly gradients of those particular curves, and we need to calculate minimum radius for those particular horizontal curves by using these values, 80 kilometers per hour and 100 kilometers per hour. That means gradient R equal to, we are having formula, R equal to V square by 127 E plus F. F is the friction, normally friction equal to 0.15, F equal to 0.15 we are taking. E also samely as previously we taken for maximum value this kind, and minimum value we have a certain amount. These are the different kinds we have explained previously. Okay, E equal to 7 to 10%. In this problem also, we need to take the minimum values and maximum values for elevation and friction. The formula is R equal to V square by 127 in the normal cases. 127 Once again, I will wrote the formula and explain how this radius will come. E equal to V square by 127 R we are having. Normal formula for calculating elevation. But in terms of radius, the R value equal to R equal to V square by 127 E. Why? Because this E value will be exchanged from left hand side to right hand side, so that the radius of the horizontal curve will be changing. In the entire second chapter, we have to use this formula for calculating both velocity, design of velocity and design of radius of the curve and design of super elevation and design of friction. Only this formula you need to remember, and minimum values and maximum values for elevation and radius and velocities are also responsible for first chapter. We are having design speeds in different ways, normally expressways, national highways, state highways, major district roads, other district roads. So that we need to have some two values, F value equal to constant 0.15, E equal to 7 to 10%. We also depends upon vehicular speed, R thing we need to calculate. If we given the R value, we have to calculate elevation. If elevation is given, R value we have to calculate. Okay, this is the major problems in all the second chapters, all of the second chapter. ATKMPH 100 kilometers. Both ATKMPH, what is the ruling terrain we have, and 100 kilometers, what is the ruling terrain we need. In one class, I will explain for each and every value how we have to calculate with some sorts of examples we taken from the textbook and other university papers also. Next one is the widening of the pavement on these horizontal curves. Widening of pavement means particularly whenever there is a overtaking of particular span of the road, we have to provide this extra widening because to counteract these accidents and crashings, head-on collisions and side clashings like that, we need to have some sort of extra widening of the particular road surface. On horizontal curves, especially when they are not very large radii. Radii means large radii. Horizontal curve having small radius without having large radius. That means large radii ledante manaki small radius unnatte. Whenever we are having small sort of radius, we need to have see this extra widening of the pavement. Once I will show the vertical diagrams. This is the extra widening. I will show with this vehicular diagram. This is the radius of the particular curve. Normally, the width of the road is, this is the width of the road. But in case of this radius is very large, we are providing some sort of this extra widening because to eliminate these crashings and others while we are going on a particular radius. This is the extra widening. Okay, you have a better idea. The dotted part is the dotted portion represents the extra widening. All this is the dotted portion. I redden the some amount of portion. The redden portion will be the extra widening portion, which was prescribed for those particular radius of the curve, related to the radius of the curve. Okay, widening is needed for the following reasons. Why we have to create this extra widening for such kind of roads? That means, first of all, the driver experience difficult steeping around the curve. Steep means normally slope, steepy means slopey. The driver experiences difficulties, that means they have to face difficulties. They don't have to observe the vehicles, what are the vehicles they are going, on those particular curves because of lack of this overtaking side distance, stopping side distance and others. If the side distance is very much easier to the driver, the vehicle is going very smoothly on the vehicle. Otherwise, we have to face some sort of problems. Next one we are having is the vehicle occupies the greater width as the rear wheel don't drag the front wheel. That means it is called tracking. That means manaki vehicular length that totally depends upon the distance between the front wheel and back wheel. While we are taking some amount of turnings, we have to face a few problems with this front wheel is not sufficiently moving along the particular road, so that we have to face these problems. If the extra winding is there, automatically the front wheel will move in a particular direction, so that there will be no problem to the driver and to the traffic also. So that we have to use this extra widening for vehicle's movement in a particular radiuses. That means normally vehicle is moving means we have to change our direction of the front wheel, so that the vehicle will have to move in a particular radius. If the vehicle is going in a straight line, we won't have to change our tire direction. If the vehicle is moving in a radial direction, that means we need to have some change in the tire movement, so that we have to simply go in the particular radial path. Otherwise, we have to go in a straight lines, so that we need some amount of extra widening while we are facing this radial curves. Third point we are having is the greater visibility of the curve. The driver have tendency not to follow central path of the lane, but he has to use outer side of the beginning of the curve. That means the total point explains about the greater visibility. That means what are the vehicles they are coming in. One lane we are going, in another lane the vehicles we are coming, but in case of lesser widening, the outer wheel vehicles, they are what are coming to the particularly at the center point, we want to have accessibility to visible. That means not accessibility for vision of the front coming vehicles to the driver because of this lack of this extra widening. If there is extra widening, means automatically the total road length and width and coming vehicles are also visible to the driver and having accessibility to free flotation of the vehicle and tire movements. Next, fourth point we are having, two vehicles cross or overtake at a particular horizontal curve. There is a physiological tendency to maintain a greater clearance between those vehicles safely. That means if there is a huge amount of widening, that means there should be a distance between two vehicles while they are crossing. That means normally we have to maintain 3.5 meters for single lane road, 7 meters for double lane roads. In particularly some of the cases we have to maintain 7.5 meters. Why? Because to have a better driving, that means we have a better tendency to clear the two vehicles while they are crossing each other. That means they are crossing each other means they are moving in a particular road in opposite directions. They don't have to clash. The clashing means there is a less space between those vehicles. We need to give some amount of extra widening to counteract these amount of clashings, side clashings like that. So this extra widening of pavement is useful extremely in these horizontal curves. The next one we are having, off tracking. What is a off tracking? First of all, we have to know what is off tracking. An automobile has a rigid wheel base and only the front wheels can be turned. That means where any automobile or any bike or any car or any lorry or a tractor, whatever it may be, in all of those kind of vehicles, motor vehicles, we are having only front wheel accessibility for moving in direction, according to the direction. That means if we are going to the left side, we need to move our steering in left direction. We have to go on right direction, we need to move in right direction. Only accessibility is given to the front wheels only. There is no accessibility to the back wheels. Why? Because there is two accessibilities. That means automatically vehicle are having a completely different clashings will be come, because when we are in unknown conditions, that means if there is two means, our driver's vision should not be in single path, so that they are giving accessibility in one direction. If there is two accessibilities, means in indirectly we moving both to front wheel and back wheel in opposite direction, automatically vehicle will rotates at a particular point. As you understand, if there is an accessibility to two wheels, that means if two are moving in opposite directions, that means the force will act on a particular point with respect to two, that means there may be a chance of coupling at a particular point, so that the total vehicle will skid and other vehicles will be affected due to these two accessibilities of front wheel and back wheel, so that there will be only one accessibility was given to the vehicles to counteract this couple acting on the particular vehicles. I will show with the example. It is a vehicle, that means normally it is a lorry. We are having, these are the front wheels and these are the back wheels. Suppose these front wheels are moving in this direction, back wheels are moving in this direction, that means there may be two forces acting on a particular direction, that means there may be a couple of forces acting on the vehicle, so that the vehicle skids or rotates in a particular point. This is the center point of the vehicle, so that one vehicle is moving in one direction, another wheel is moving in the another direction, so that the total vehicle will be drawn in circular motion, so that there will be one, we have only accessibility to front wheels only, not we are having accessibility to back wheels. To negotiate particularly on the horizontal curve, we are having same path as that front wheels. The phenomena is called as the off tracking. Automobiles are having only one wheel movement, although the wheel movement is front wheel in different directions, there is only front wheel movement, that is called as a off tracking. The required extra widening of the pavement at a horizontal curve is depends upon the length of the wheelbase of the vehicle and the radius of the curve. This wheelbase and radius of the curve having effect on this length of the vehicle. Normally in India we are moving, most of the vehicles are length is fixed. For lorries and other things we are having huge amount of length, so that we are designed according to their length criteria. In a few routes are designed with a large radius. Why? Because normally in the shipyards, okay, in the shipyards and we are having these airports, we have to transport and we have to draw the some of the few parts from the outer countries, so that we need to transport or we need to మనం వాళ్ళ దగ్గర నుంచి ఎగుమతి కానీ దిగుమతి కానీ చేసుకోవాలి కొన్ని కొన్ని వస్తువులు. వై? బికాజ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు యూజ్ అవర్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్ ప్రాపర్టీస్, దట్ మీన్స్ మన యొక్క ఇండస్ట్రీస్ని మనం ఎన్లార్జ్మెంట్ చేసుకోవడానికి అండ్ బైఫర్కేషన్ చేసుకోవడానికి యొక్క యూటిలిటీస్ అనేవి మన యొక్క ఫారెన్ కంట్రీస్ నుంచి కొన్ని కొన్నిసార్లు మనం కొనుక్కుంటూ వస్తాం. వై? బికాజ్ వీ ఆర్ నాట్ హ్యావింగ్ సమ్ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఫీజబిలిటీ టు మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చర్ దోస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలిమెంట్స్. In some cases we are having, because their volume is so much high, particularly in turbines and other vehicular movements and other things, we are having huge amount of volume and weight basis, so that to bear those kind of metals and other things, we have to use a large span vehicles for those movements, so that in some of the areas extremely where there is a huge amount of shipyards and these locations and transporting mediums like railways, extremely for those kind of areas we have accessibility for these design conditions to these industrial areas, to these mainly transporting areas we are having large amount of wheel base designs. In normal areas we have to go for normal lorries which are having 16 tire lorries and 20 tire lorries having their length, they will be considered those lengths and design the particular routes. Next one is the extra widening curves. How they are dividing? mechanical winding and physiological winding. Already these things are discussed, mechanical winding and physiological winding. This is another PPT having huge amount of matter on those particular diagrams, mechanical winding and physiological winding. The total winding depends upon these two factors, both mechanical winding, physiological winding. Winding required to account the tracking due to rigidity of wheel base is called mechanical winding. That means the total mechanical winding is depends upon the wheel base and wheel movement. And physiological winding is depends upon extra width of the pavement is also provided on the physical reasonings. That means different reasons are, as previously we discussed, to import and export different sorts of mechanical equipments and other things to countries and to our country. That means we need to import and we have to export. Means India are majorly importing different helicopters and other related to army vehicles are importing from France and America and other countries, and we are exporting our agricultural products and our other basic products which are manufacturing in our country to the other countries. Like pharma products and agricultural products are, we are mainly exporting to other countries. In recent COVID conditions also, we are exporting huge amount of medical purposes to other countries, like drugs and others. That means pharma drugs, chloroquine and other injections and other things required to treat these patients in other poor countries. So that likely we are having different kinds of facilities to facilitate those things to other countries. We need basically this transportation to import and export, so that we have some amount of extra widening for large span of vehicles that are having huge amount of capability to bear those loads. That means these goods and others. Physiological reasons to provide greater maneuverability and steeping at the high speed at a low for the extra space overthink of the vehicles and provide a greater clearance at crossings. That means crossings means these radiuses are horizontal curves and vertical curves. We are having some sort of radial crossings. Okay, to cross those particular roads, we are having extra widenings and physiological widenings. The total widening is related to those two things, mechanical widening with respect to movement of the wheel, and next one is with respect to physiological conditions, extra widenings. Both PS means physiological curves and mechanical WM. This is the off tracking of the particular widening of the horizontal curve, inner radius and outer radius, R1 and R2. L is the total length of the curve, OABC, here we are in O at the center point, A is the first point, B is the second point, C is the extra widening point from particular point B to another. Okay, this is the diagram. This is the mechanical widening, R1 and R2. R1 is the initial radius, R1 is the normal radius, R2 is the extra widening radius. R2 minus R1 gives the extra widening part. That means in terms of mechanical widening, so that we need to find those extra widening from triangle OAB, where A is the particular length point, AB is the length of the particular alignment. We are having L, R1 square, R2 square minus L square. Simply WM we are having R2 minus R1. So that R2 equal to WM minus R1 we are having. R2 equal to WM minus R1 or R1 equal to R2 minus WM. Those two things we have kept from the first equation, WM equal to R2 minus R1. So that we are having R1 equal to R2 minus WM, both terms with respect to R2 we are having. L square equal to, in the first equation we are having R2 common, so that we are getting length equal to WM of 2 into R2 minus WM. Extra widening required equal to L square by 2 R2 minus WM. So this is the value. So that extra winding equal to L square by 2R. Wm equal to NL square by 2R. That means N equal to number of lanes. This is the road we are having normally. We are keeping some amount of extra widening in terms of length, where R is the mean radius from the particular curve. N equal to number of traffic lanes. R equal to mean radius of the particular curve in terms of meters. L equal to 6 meters. We need to have some amount of 6.1 meters for common vehicles, where V is the design speed for particular type of road. It is a expressway, we have to design speed is 120, national highway, or it is a 100 kilometers per hour, major district roads 80 kilometers per hour. Like that, design speed we need to maintain according to the kind of the road. R is the normal radius of the curve. L equal to length of the wheel base. It depends upon vehicle. Normally we design for a large span vehicle so that short span vehicles will cross easily in these curves. If we design for a short span vehicle, large span vehicles will have to face problems. So that we need to go for a better value, as large as possible. That means we have to face minimum problems. Next one, we are having physiological widening. That means WPS. Previously we designed mechanical widening, but here we are having physiological widening. For this physiological widening, we are having directly formula with respect to IRC, that is equal to V by 9.5 R, because it is an empirical formula where V is the design speed, R is the curve. Okay, those things we are at W equal to NL square by 2 R plus V square by R. This measure, these are the points which are used to measure of extra widening. And this is the length showing with the extra widening, normal radius, and S is the extra widening length with respect to those two curves. This shows the how vehicles will move on those particular extra widening curves. Why? Because we are observing a two wheel, that means four wheeler, that's our small cars moving in back and in front of the this large span vehicle. Here we are having a large span vehicle is the, particularly this bus is a large span vehicle in the particular situation, and we are having some amount of small vehicles that are cars. That is a totally hilly region, that means mountainous terrains we are facing in this particular condition. So we are having a side slopes and others, vertical profile side slopes and others. We are having some amount of bushes and others. This is the introduction. Total class on these extra widenings, transition curves and other curves, we are having this amount of sharp curves. That means especially in terms of hilly roads, this is the sharp curve. That means sharp means normally sharp term we are using with respect to indicate a knife. That means normally knife is the shape of this. It means it is a sharp curve. That means the point is like a knife. This is a round curve, that is not sharp curve. Transition curves and we are having with transition curve, without transition curve, and sharp curves. Those things we need to maintain. Okay, these things you need to remember. What is a sharp curve? That means the curve which is in the shape of knife. Those called sharp curves.